Hey, Cyrus. Still kind of getting stuff together. Hello. Hey. Do you guys want me to get my, like, palette in the frame, or just these? Squished some of her fur. If I can get it to focus on the foreground in this one. So yeah, this one still needs to be baked. Just finished it right at the last minute. I'm gonna smooth this one out with isopropyl alcohol and then throw it in the oven while I get started painting this one. Oh yeah, and I was gonna play music this time. Let's see. I got just a little bit of color in the white to make it look a little more natural. And then I'm gonna go over the whole thing, I think, with whites so that the layers after it have a better, like, underlayer. A little bit brighter. Oh, that's cool, Thyrus. Who's the artist who did it? Oh, I think she might have actually just watched me on Amino. That's cool. So I'm keeping this layer really thin because tiny details like this fur and the teeth could just get wiped out with a really thick layer of paint. And if it's not wide enough, which it's not, I'll just go over it with the second thin layer. Thank you. Thanks. Whoa. Shit. The other one just fell over in the oven. Fursuits are pretty cool because of how collaborative they end up being between the designer and the person who owns the character and usually ends up modifying it in some way, and then the maker themselves. I always kind of wondered how the designer of the character would feel about the fursuit being made of something they came up with. Whether they like it or not, but it sounds like it's okay. Pre-made is just about to get the fur glue down to it. It's pretty much all sewn together. Actually at about the same stage that your suit's at. Acrylic dries really fast, but not quite so much with this watered-down stuff, so I think I'm going to grab a hair dryer and kind of speed this along. Thank you. I'm gonna get a black in the eyes before they completely fill up with paint. Let's see. Painting one on, because I think that gives it a little more depth, and the pupil actually as a whole on a real eye. And I think before another layer of white, I'm gonna get the mouth color on there. I guess not much of this time are actually showing, but give me blue. Using kind of shitty paint like I am. Sorry, I don't know what counts as a swear. It can be hard to get the colors like saturated enough. I really need to go just get some better paint. This will serve okay for inside the mouth, but for the rest of this guy's blue, I think I'm gonna have to go get some actual paint instead of El Cheapo. Okay. I'm gonna paint like right over the teeth and then come back in later with white, and so that'll give the illusion that, not the illusion, but it'll make it easier to paint the gums basically. Outside the lines, because I can paint back over later. second layer of white. Hopefully that's all it needs. Looks like it's gonna need a third layer. Sorry, my live streams are always so slow. I'm not sure if I'm gonna keep doing them or not, honestly. This would be an interesting color scheme for a character, just all white except blue teeth. Thank you. Yeah, I swear a lot in real life, and it kind of gets out whether I'm trying to make it all ages or not, so sorry. Get the other one. That's cool. Have fun dancing. What kind of dancing do you do, by the way? She fell down in the oven, and I got paint on her. Let's see. Oh, cool. Do you have a YouTube channel, like, for dancing? Cool, well, I'll see you, or not see you, I'll talk to you later. Just gonna put this temper early on, try to get her to stand up a little better. Thought it was balanced until it fell over in the oven there. So her base color is gold. We'll start with that. I'm just gonna do like straight gold out of two. Thanks, yeah, she's definitely living up to her name already. Burning my fingers. Ah! Super gold. So Golden Wolfo is her like face fur supposed to also be like this metallic, like basically a bronze, or is it less glittery? And then her nose is kind of natural too, or so it's just basically her hair is gold. She almost looks cast out of gold at this point. Sorry, I feel like I should have done this base layer before I started the stream. I'm still kind of figuring out what's boring and what's exciting to watch. I don't know, it's all kind of boring to watch, I'd imagine. That's why everybody speeds their art streams up to like times six. I at least like the music I found. There's not very much good public domain stuff, but this stuff is. I got like a copy strike or something the other night because I was working on the fursuit head and watching Monty Python, and just that being in the background. And stream stopped, but it was after like 2 hours of Monty Python, so didn't get to it very fast. But I was gonna replace the audio afterwards anyways. Okay, I'm gonna go back for one more white. Passing the other one. So did you design Golden Leaf yourself then? Finally got full saturation here. I think what I should do is just spray paint a primer coat on these before I get started next time. Are these both your guys' first personas, or did you have ones before this? Thank you. I'm actually not that great at making characters either. It took me a really long time to come up with the current version of my Sona. And even then, that was like kind of a new version of like stuff I've been developing for years and years. And then I only have like that one in my partner's character. And haven't really made a character that I've used recently. Besides those two. I just get too like hung up on like choice paralysis. There's too many options. Especially since I like so many different kinds of animals. I'm not just starting from like, which kind of canine do I want, what colors do I want in it. It's like, which of these million billion species should I choose or make one up, like I usually end up doing. I think it's pretty much just you two and me watching at this point, which is fine, because all I've done is paint and white. Let's see. I don't even know what time it is. It's not late at all. Looks like a color for her body. I ended up running out of paint, so I'm just gonna make a ton of it. actually gonna pull up their reference sheets. I don't know how well the camera's picking it up, but I'm really liking how warm the colors are. Let me put the layer of gold under there. Thank you. Thanks. I'm actually gonna go over parts of the gold with this just because I think it'll look good on the roots. Dang it. Get it a little darker here. That's kind of all there is to painting, just lots of layers, that's the way I do it. now it's not quite as much of just a flat gold. I'll probably go back over it with gold and maybe a little bit of a light blonde on the highlights. Before I forget, I'm gonna start them on the eyes. So we'll get the pink. Actually, her. Let's see. I'm gonna put this in. Let's see. In where her flesh was. I kinda wish I hadn't put the eye behind quite so much here. Well. Let's actually get that on the other one too. Scratch that, we're gonna do black on this one, I guess. No, I want his eyelashes to stand out. I don't know. Okay. Let's actually start working on this one again. So now I can just go over the teeth all at once, and I still get a little bit of blue in between. And this is how I did the zipper on the vulture sculpture. You don't have to paint each individual one. Just do the darker color first. Change my mind and do black on that. Dang it. Got some pink into the eye, which is kind of what you want. Kind of like bloodshot, but a little bit of color in there is good. Oh, that's fine. Thank you. Yours is very well camouflaged right now. had a little panic moment thinking the whites of her eyes might not be white.
Thank you.
thought his hair was white. Spent a lot of time avoiding that for no reason. Let's see. I'm gonna come in with a darker color first. Thank you. I came up with them over the course of a long time. They kind of looked basically the same shape as they are now from the start. The feral form anyways, like a cat-like thing. But their color was always a lot more drab, like solid gray with like black marks around the eyes. Which was me trying to kind of fit what I felt like my personality actually was at the time. Sorry, I'm trying to concentrate and talk at the same time. Had like this view of myself that I'm a very drab, not very interesting person. And I had this idea that fursonas always have to like be really, really honest, regardless of if you end up actually liking them or not. So I was never like that big on it for a while. But then with this redesign, I finally went with what I actually like. Which is, you can see it in like their wiki, there's a bunch of different animals that I based their new colors on. And before they didn't have scales on their face either, it was just like feather fur all over, which also looked boring. So that kind of helped like break up the shapes of their face a little bit and actually made them easier to draw, because before they kind of just looked like a Muppet with like no features on their face. I went through a ridiculous amount of different color schemes this last redesign in preparation for making a suit, because I knew it would be really hard to change the design after the suit was finished. I still feel like changing the design sometimes, but now it's kind of locked in, which is kind of a good thing, actually. Otherwise, I'd just keep obsessing over it. I think I am gonna still change the tail. And then their name. I'm quarter Japanese, and I've always felt like I wasn't connected enough to, like, my heritage. Even though I've always had like a passing interest in Japanese folklore, so their name Oni is related to like demons or ogres in that folktale, which again sounds kind of like negative, which I guess goes along with my opinion of myself, but also, I don't know, there's just kind of like a power in evil characters. Not necessarily evil, it's just like evil, the way it was traditionally viewed, seems to be more like a force of nature and chaos that we don't, it's just kind of the name for the thing that we don't understand, which I'm attracted to. I feel like it goes well with my gender and their mix of species that went into their design. It's just very ambiguous, and I can't like give a definitive answer for what my gender or their species or any of that actually is, which, I don't know, I like being mysterious or something. Does that answer your question, like, way too much, or? I don't know, as far as like coming up with the species, I don't really think of it as a species. People always ask me, like, is that a velociraptor? Is that an original species? And I don't really think of it like that, or my partner's persona, Leon, where he's like a mix of like a caribou and a moose and like some lion thrown in there and just like everything. I like character designers for like, you know, classic sci-fi, like The Thing and Star Wars and stuff, and I think of it more as just like creature design for one single character rather than designing a whole new species. And I don't know, I just really like the body language, the way that cats move, so that's like their body shape, and then with a little bit of reptile and bird thrown in just because those tend to be my favorite types of animals. I have 2 ringneck doves as pets, and my partner has a hognose snake. How did you come up with your persona, or at least Golden Leaf had mentioned that you had other personas before this one. So why not like a bat in particular, or an African wild dog instead of a mix of both? Sorry, I'm still talking weirdly. I can't paint and talk at the same time. No, that's all really interesting too. I wish more people incorporated bats into their fursonas. They're really interesting, and I think that like the number of species of bats are more than like every other type of mammal or something, but they're really underappreciated, I guess because we don't see them in our everyday lives, but... African wild dogs would be fun to do, like, draw a whole pack or something of anthros, just have them take up, like, the full canvas, have only, like, their coat patterns making up the whole composition, because it's just so painterly already. What are soaps? I don't know what soaps. Is that an acronym like Dutch Angel Dragons Dads? Sorry, I've kind of gotten stuck on this one instead of painting that one. It's partly because I don't have a good blue right now. I'll probably keep recording and post the video later. I feel like I make a little bit less progress than I normally would when I'm on camera. Oh, okay. Thank you. Does Soya basically not have eyebrows? He has blue eyebrows in some of the pictures. And the brown shape above his eye is a little bit different across all of them. Okay, do you see what I mean about the brown shape over his eyes? So on the latest breath you gave me, it's like, kind of just like ends at his eye, and then on some of the other ones it crosses more like into the middle of his face, and you can see the point of the triangle there. Okay, so let's see. Like that, or like all the way to where his eyelash is gonna be. Oh, okay, cool. What is the bottom of this shape like? Is it like a rectangle straight across, or does it come at a point, or like a U shape? Thank you. gonna end the stream. Thanks for helping me out with all the colors. It's a public domain music channel called let's see. Chez Monsplaisir, ChezMonPlaisir. If you sent a link, I didn't see it, but anyhow, good night, everybody, and thanks for watching.